DeWalt batteries are very simple compared to Milwaukee and Makita. Instead of microcontrollers, they just use analog pins that let the tool in charge and measure low voltage or overtemp. But sometimes simplicity can be better, so let's find out how DeWalt checks for low voltage and overtemp, what charging method they use, and how they balance their batteries. DeWalt batteries have pins for all 5 cells, a thermistor and an ID resistor. The circuit board is pretty simple and has been sketched by a few people. The important parts are a 10 kilo ohm thermistor for temperature measurement and an ID resistor to tell the charger what's the maximum charging current. This chip seems to be a custom chip that is labeled V6B. It's almost certainly an overvoltage protection chip, as taking any cell over 4.28 volts turns off this MOSFET, which floats the ID resistor and stops the charger. 4.28 volts is pretty high, as 4.25 volts is usually listed as the maximum. The tool only makes use of the thermistor and C3 pin, which is the voltage of the third cell. On this tool, both pins are only read for 1 millisecond every 10 milliseconds, but other tools may be different, especially cheaper brush tools without a microcontroller. The tool draws 95 microamps from the thermistor pin and 120 microamps from the C3 pin. As it's on a 10% duty cycle, it's actually drawing 0.95 and 1.2 milliamps, from which we can deduce that both have about 10 kilo ohm input impedance. The thermistor is 10 kilo ohm at 25 Celsius and lowers as the temperature increases. The tool works normally down to 2.56 kilo ohm. Below 2.55, the light will flash. Below 2.14, and the tool shuts off. 2.14 kilo ohm corresponds to 58 Celsius, which is on the lower end, as most data sheets say a max of 75 or 80 Celsius. This is good to see that DeWalt isn't pushing the cells too hard. The C3 pin is used as a basic low voltage detection. It has a narrow range for startup, but a wider range once the tool is running. Startup is around 2.78 volts per cell for the first 3 cells and 2.65 volts per cell for the 4th and 5th cells, but only if they're perfectly balanced. Once running, the cutoff criteria is effectively 2 volts per cell for both the upper and lower limits. I'm surprised that they'd go this low when they don't have individual cell monitoring. The C3 voltage limits go a bit wacky if you try to trick it with a voltage divider. A 2K-3K divider shrinks the upper and lower limits by around 1 volt. 4K-6K shrinks at another volt, and by 6K-9K it's effectively impossible to start the tool. I'm guessing most adapters for DeWalt tools use something around 2K-3K, which is going to give you 2 to 4 milliamps of parasitic draw. DeWalt chargers make use of all the pins. The ID pin is used to tell the charger what the max charging current should be. With the DCB118, which is an 8 amp charger, I got the following charging currents for each range of ID resistance. The 2 amp hour charges at 4 amps, which is what the cells are rated to. This is a minor win for DeWalt over Milwaukee, as Milwaukee allows their 2 amp to charge at 6 amps on the rapid charger. Milwaukee has the battery request current from the charger via digital protocol, but for some reason the 2 amp hour has been programmed to request 6 amps rather than 4 amps. DeWalt chargers do not seem to have a minimum pack voltage requirement. I drained a battery down to 6 volts, which is well below the recommended minimum of 12.5 volts, and it started charging without issue. It seems to give a small test current for about a second, and if the voltage response is within limits, it'll start charging. DeWalt chargers do not use constant current, constant voltage charging, which is the recommended method for lithium ion. Instead, they charge at constant current until the battery reaches a voltage threshold. Then it drops back to half of the original current until it hits a second threshold. Then charging stops. I also bought the new DCB1104, as it's a new charger that was released in July 2023 and is advertised as having two-stage charging. I'm in 240 volt land, so it doesn't say two-stage on the sticker, but the images imply the same thing. This charger charged at 4 amps, then changed to 2 amps, then stopped. There was no constant voltage phase where the current steadily decreased. So unless we're getting very different chargers outside of North America, I don't think the two-stage chargers do constant current, constant voltage. It's still doing the same full current, half current charging like the older chargers, with the only change being that the LEDs show you when it changes to the half current top-up. Now we get to the part where DeWalt takes a big L. Despite the chargers having pin access to all the cells, as far as I can tell, DeWalt chargers do not balance charge. I had a hard time believing this, so I tested it multiple times and even bought this newer charger just to be sure. I pushed a cell higher and lower, but never saw any current through the cell pins. I found circuit diagrams for 3 DeWalt chargers, and none of them have circuitry for balancing. The cell pins only go into this small chip, which is marked as V8F, and seems to be an overvoltage chip like on the batteries. I took apart my DCB1104, which required hacking away at the silicone, and found no balancing chips, just a microcontroller and another chip that's probably overvoltage. This is pretty bad for Dewalt to release a charger in 2023 that does not balance charge. I would love to be wrong about this, so if anyone can demonstrate a Dewalt charger that gives balancing current, please make a video and post it in the comments. Overall, the battery design is fine. It mostly achieves the same things as the more advanced batteries, and does so with much lower complexity. Unfortunately, they're really let down by their chargers.